please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Okay, now take a look at L&T. That's the one which is now taking the market higher, 1.5% in just the last hour of trade on L&T, and that stock at high point. Basant Maheshwari is with us, of course, a veteran investor. Basant, good afternoon. So, you know, over the last 2 or 3 weeks, we have heard this term melt up. Are we part of a melt up right now?
Good afternoon. Good to be again with you after a while. I mean, if you look at it on the market on a broad scale, there is no sectoral approach at the moment. Any stock goes up, any stock goes up even more and then more. So basically, people are chasing price and not performance. So the problem in this kind of a market is it's very easy to make money, but it's very difficult to retain what you have made. So on a broad scale, I think the results that would come in this quarter and the quarter after that, that's going to again rephrase the entire move. But right now, the market also hides more than what it reveals. Look at the Sensex, look at the Nifty, it's at all-time highs, and the mid caps and the small caps, they've been down 5, 7, 10% over the last couple of weeks. I'm talking on a broad scale. So I think those things are going to get revisited. We've seen this several times when stocks keep going up like that. There's again a rethink, and the rethink would come very soon. That's what I feel on the kind of stocks that are going up, really.
Okay. Just looking at the price action, 4% up in just, you know, a month alone. That's what we are talking about, Basant. Good afternoon. Good to have you on the show. I don't know, I mean, there's obviously a pre-budget fervor and flavor to this as well, and it happens to be during the third quarter earnings season and numbers seem to be all right. But do you find the last, you know, bits of this rally, 10,000 plus onwards, grounded in solid reality? Do you think it's good for more?
No, I mean, if you look at it, the results should be good because optically we are fighting a demonetization quarter. So all companies would report good earnings, but markets would look ahead of that. There's no problem in the large caps, if you ask me. There's no problem in the companies that are reporting earnings. The problem is in these one-off names that keep going up and the kind of stocks which people chase off and on. So if you look at it on a broad scale, I mean, Axis Bank, it reported good results, obviously, and the worst seems to be behind. There was a private equity investor who got in about a couple of months back. So these kind of solid names are where people should focus, and not the kind where, you know, you say, let's buy this for about 3 weeks, 4 weeks, for one month, 2 months, not those type of names. So if you have to get stuck, like you know, in Hindi, they say, marna hai to bade doctor se maro, chote doctor se mat maro. So if you want to get stuck, go and get stuck in an Axis Bank. No recommendation. I'm just giving a thought here.
Okay. You know, for long, you have been very bullish on housing finance, Basant. You know, a lot of people believe that maybe there's a bit of a subprime sort of building up here. And, you know, there's a lot of loan against property. A lot of companies are now getting their almost 80 to 90% of profitability out of LAP, even if LAP is not a large component of their book. Do you think that's fair, or are you still bullish on housing finance selectively?
No. I'm bullish on housing finance. If you just look at it, because of RERA and GST, not so much GST, because of RERA, there was a temporary slowdown. I think the slowdown is behind us now. All that had to happen has happened. So the worst is behind and the best is yet to come. I think just see DHFL's result. Of course, we don't own it, but just for your this thing. So over the next couple of quarters, I think this quarter, it's going to set the pace in. And from April onwards, you're going to see the entire sector take off again. So that's fine because, you know, they've had such a tremendous run. Obviously, nobody wants to see their stocks even pause for a minute on the screen. So if a stock is going up, you want it to go one way. But that's not how life is. So I think after this quarter, or maybe after the December quarter, I think things are going to be back again. And we are completely bullish. We are the way we were. We must have only added to these names. We haven't sold anything. And as they come down and as the money comes in, you keep buying more of them. Because as long as you have the backup of performance, I think price will come. That's not an issue at all. But about the LAP part, there are a couple of companies who are more into the LAP thing, but we are not invested into them. And secondly, LAP is given on cash flows, not on, you own a house, you go to a housing finance company and say, give me some money against it. They won't give it to you. They expect you to repay off the LAP with the cash flow of your business. And one more thing which is going around on news right now is after the PSU bank recap, there was this talk of the PSU banks going and lending money. So first, if you look at it, SBI's 1 lakh crore loan book, a primary part of that loan book has been created out of securitized assets that they buy from people like India Bulls, for example, and things like that. And secondly, PSU banks have a cost to income of 40-45%, the private banks also. Housing finance companies have a cost to income of only 15%. So cost of funds is just one factor. The other factor of setting the business economics is the cost to funds. So the cost to funds of these banks are 45%, and they are competing with the private financiers of a cost to income of a cost of funds of about 15%. So there's a huge gap. So I mean, the talk of the PSU banks being given lower cost funds and all that, that's all fine on paper, but it won't work on reality. It hasn't worked for 20 years, it won't work more.
Okay, by the way, that's really a strong set of numbers from V-Guard. Once again, 41% higher net profit, 35.8 crore versus 25.3 crores. Revenue also up 19% at 523.5 crore versus 441.2 crores. So these are the companies which went through some pain, you know, in terms of demon quarter and GST quarter. So this is where, you know, the base effect is really playing out, Surbhi. But this, I think, is really a strong set of number coming in right now on V-Guard. I would want to see the margin picture as well. Again, it's a stock which had a big correction after its last quarter's numbers. After that, a big rally. So, interesting stock, of course.
Absolutely. Today is such a day. I mean, it's mid-caps, it's large-caps, it's firing on all fronts. I mean, now 10,970 has already been taken out. I mean, we've still got about 21 minutes of trade left. Basant, now the question is, I mean, what to buy? Everything is running. Everything seems to be moving. Barring, I think, pharma, where you still have to get your companies right. You need to do a lot of sort of, you know, bottom-up selection. Even IT for that matter, large cap IT, mid cap IT, who would have thought? What's your prime bet at this moment?
No, IT, if you look at it, it's more of a macro call. Because if the dollar doesn't go back to 65, 66, our exports won't be encouraged and imports, you know, obviously. So the government has to, government or the RBI, they have to let the rupee slip a little bit. So the market is taking that ahead of itself, and the market says if from 64 it goes to 66, then these exporters make money. So IT is the best bet, and obviously the under ownership and the over ownership things come back. But whatever you buy, my only thing is you shouldn't be buying just price. So over a period of time, the mid caps and the small caps, they've done fine. I think the rally will shift to the mid stroke the large caps, the Nifty names. But Nifty also, if you look at it, a couple of stocks are holding up the Nifty. For example, Infosys and HUL and maybe the HDFC banks over there. So the underlying thesis right now, the market being broad-based, the rally is broad-based at the small cap and the mid cap. In the large cap space, it's still very narrow. But personally for us, we are betting on private financials. So they've been quiet for 2-3 months. I think that's going to change now. With the results, they should be fine.